Programming can be a really gratifying experience for a lot of people, but if you make some mistakes, it can really take the fun out of it. Hey everyone, I'm Shyam Sharma, and in this video, I'll be talking about 5 mistakes that you must avoid if you are starting into programming. If you are a beginner programmer, if you are learning a particular language, if you want to become a software developer, these are some mistakes that you must avoid if you want to get to that particular place quicker. You can make these mistakes, you can learn from them later in life, but you would have, wasted a bunch of your time. So I'll just be helping you out with that. Okay. This video is most importantly for people that just started programming. Maybe you are in your first year of college or even second year of college and you just started picking up a few programming concepts. That's what this video is centered towards. So let's get started. The first concept is going to be, or the first mistake I should say, is going to be to not code consistently every single day. Now, this is one of the biggest mistakes that I think a lot of people make. Even I made this mistake when I was starting to code back in my day, like 1.5 years ago. So I started programming, but I was not coding consistently. This is a problem that a lot of people have with other things as well in life. So I would highly suggest you to treat coding as a habit, right? So whenever you have a habit, you have to practice, you have to give it time, you have to, maybe even you're doing 1 hour of coding, but you do it every single day. That habit that you will inculcate in yourself is going to pay off in dividends for your entire life. Okay, so make sure that you are coding consistently every single day. A lot of people don't do that, but I think it's extremely important. Try to use the Pomodoro technique or just schedule some time. Okay, have that time free in your day that, okay, from this time to this time, I'll just be programming and that's all that I would do. Take out all the distractions and focus on programming particularly. Okay, believe me, the changes that you will see is going to be crazy. If you want to, try some methods, you can try the 100 days of code. I have made a special video for all of you talking about why are you procrastinating while coding and how to avoid procrastination as a programmer. Okay, so you can look at that video as well. I'll be linking it in the description. But moving on to the next point, this point is going to be learning too many languages early on in your journey of a programmer. So what happens is that you might have heard that there are tons and tons of languages out there. So a lot of people think that I should learn these languages if I want to be a successful programmer. So what they do is that they try to learn something from Java, something from C++, something from Python, something from JavaScript. And at the end of the day, they know little bits of information about all of these languages, but they are the master of none. Okay, so you need to understand that even if you know how to write Hello World in 20 or 50 languages, it won't matter if you cannot build an application in that particular language. Okay, it doesn't matter if you can console log out Hello World if you cannot make like a front end using JavaScript. Okay, so yeah, I just want to keep that out there. Make sure that you are learning one language at a time and going a little bit deeper into that. Okay, so that's what I want you to understand. There is a friend of mine, Kunal Kushwaha. I did an interview with him where he talks about pie-shaped learning. Okay, so that's basically about, first of all, you learn in breadth. So you learn multiple concepts, you learn multiple languages, but then you also try to focus down on few. Okay, and then go deep into that. This is called as the pie-shaped learning. This will help you to focus on a few things after you have tried multiple of them. Okay, so that's the second point. Learning too many languages early on can kill your programming journey and it can get intimidating really quickly. Moving on to the third point. All right, I like this one a lot. This one is to not make enough programming projects. So what happens is that whenever you are becoming like a programmer, a lot of the times as a programmer, you would basically be working on projects. Right. So I have interviewed software developers in all the top tech companies and they always have some program or some project that they are working on. So they have like a team and they are working on some project together. So over there, you are expected to create something. So it would be better if you have this habit of knowing what goes into building like a full stack application or how can you build like a front end. Basically, how can you start building projects? Right? That's what I want you to understand. So just spend some time into finding what projects can be for your particular tech stack. Let's say you are learning about AR, VR, then see what projects can you make. Or maybe you are learning about machine learning, see what projects can you start making. Or maybe you are learning about Java, see what projects can you make. The point here is that it's not about the idea of the project that you will start with, it's more about the learnings that you would have from those projects, okay? So just think about any application. You use Instagram all day, so might want to make an Instagram clone. You use Netflix all day, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube. Try to make a clone of that. That would teach you a lot about how to basically do routing or how to have a database, how to connect your database and things like that. You will be able to learn when you were to actually create something. So just keep this one thing in mind. If you want to get more ideas about projects, I have a video where I've explained 15 plus projects that I made in my first and second year of college. Highly recommended. Again, I'll be linking that in the description. You can look at that. And by the way, if you are liking this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. I share a lot of other tips about programming, freelancing, just that typical college life. Okay. So if you're interested, you can subscribe to my channel. Now, I also would like to mention Geeks for Geeks, which is a great place for you to learn computer programming concepts. Starting from 22nd of March, they are coming up with an interesting offer. So basically, they're launching 4 different vouchers. Basically, you can get a 800 rupee voucher for 500 rupees. You can get a 2500 rupee voucher for 1500 rupees. You can get a 4500 rupee voucher for 2500 rupees. Basically, you're going to get a lot of discount, right? You are also getting the 8000 rupee voucher for 5000 rupees only. Now, what can you do with these vouchers? You can get them and you can redeem them for Geeks for Geeks courses on their own website. Okay, now when can you redeem them? So basically, you can get these vouchers from 22nd of March and you can redeem them between 12th and 18th of April in their Geek Summer Carnival. Okay, so if you're interested and you want to invest in your learnings and if you want to become a better programmer by learning from courses, you can check out the link in description. Thank you Geeks for Geeks for sponsoring the video, and now back to the content that we were talking about. Anyways, let's move on to the fourth part, right? So the fourth part is going to be to not understanding errors. So what happens is that a lot of us, we write some program and then we try to execute it. When we do that, we get a bunch of errors. And our immediate reaction to that is to just copy that and search it up on maybe Google, and you get Stack Overflow. You go through that, you try to understand what the problem is, or you just copy paste the whole thing for the solution. That's one of the wrong things that a lot of people do. Focus a lot more into understanding what the error really means. What is the name of the error, right? So it always says in red, error, indentation error, syntax error, reference error. There are tons and tons of these errors that happen. So try to understand what sort of error that is, and then just look into your code and try to debug it. Try to understand where was the problem exactly and try to solve that right then and there, versus searching for that error and trying to fix that just by copy pasting the code from Stack Overflow. This will teach you a lot about problem solving. Okay, so yeah, I just wanted to tell that is the fourth mistake that a lot of people make. Make sure that you are learning about these errors. Just go to, let's say you're learning Python, right? So just open up the Python documentation, open up the errors page, error testing and all, and you'll find that place over there which talks about all sorts of errors that can occur in your program. Just go through that once, you'll get to learn a lot more about it. All right, everyone, now let's talk about the fifth mistake that a lot of people end up making as a programmer. And this one is to not learn about version control system or VCS and not participating in open source programs more often. So I would highly recommend all of you to do that, because one, what happens is that when you go into these top tech companies as a software developer, that's what you essentially do. You are a lot more into, you know, controlling different versions of the software, trying to use Git and GitHub. And so it's really important that you use those early on so that you get a good hang of it. So just make sure that you are putting in a lot of your time into learning about version control system, learn about Git, GitHub, how does that work? Maybe try to get all of your projects, all of your files in which you've done programming onto your GitHub profile, try to put it up there, try to make a bunch of repositories. I also have a repository in which I just upload whatever I've learned as a programmer, as a web developer actually. So that is what I used to do. It will just teach you about Git, GitHub, some commands that you might be using quite often. Just learn about open source as well, because again, this will teach you a lot about how to handle large code bases, how to make sense of it all, so as to say. You'll also be communicating with other software developers, so that would also be interesting. You would also learn about project management. How does these softwares like Jira or Trello, how do they work? How can you understand everything about that? So these things will be a lot more helpful to you. So yeah, I just wanted to talk about these five mistakes that a lot of beginner programmers make. Let me know in the comment section if you resonate with any of these mistakes, if you have made a lot of these mistakes. There are some other mistakes as well, like you have tutorial hell, in which a lot of people are just, you know, binging on courses like anything, like it's like a Netflix kind of a TV show. But yeah, don't do that. Make sure that you make projects every once in a while. Let's say you've learned HTML, CSS. Stop your learning, make a bunch of projects, then learn about JavaScript, stop right there, make a bunch of projects, go to React, make a bunch of projects, and that's how it'll go, right? So that's one thing. Then there are also some small ones like using IDEs. A lot of people use IDEs very early on when they don't even need to. Let's say you are learning web development. Just using VS Code can work out fine for you. Okay, that's what I have used so far, and I have not faced any problem. Just try to use some text editors or Visual Studio Code. That works fine for most users. Again, I use Python, I use web development, and for these two cases, it works just fine. If you are into Java, you might want to go with IntelliJ or something, but that's what I would say. Try to focus on using lightweight text editors or tools, and also avoid auto-completion. Okay, so whenever you're writing code and you are a beginner, try to write everything yourself rather than installing like some code snippets extension from VS Code, and that would not be a good activity for you in the long term, right? So that's just something to keep in mind. That is one mistake that people make. Then there's also something called as code formatting that you need to be aware of. How should you name your variables, your functions, your classes, if you are commenting your code or not, if you are using good code practices and all that. So just search up about this. I will leave some articles in description if you want to learn more about how can you format your code better. That would be really helpful for all of you. But yeah, then just understand about debugging. How can you debug your code? What is testing? How to use testing? When I made my first commit into some open source organization, I didn't know what testing was. There was something called as a Travis CLI. I didn't know what that mean. Okay, so that took me a while to understand that, okay, this is how testing works. This is what I need to do to make sure my code passes all the tests. So that's what I would want to share with you. These were some mistakes that beginner programmers make. Let me know in the comment section what are your thoughts about this. You can also follow me on Instagram at ishansharma7390. I share a lot of other resourceful content. If you are in college, if you are learning programming, do follow me over there as well. Check out my other videos on programming over here. And I hope to see you in the next video. Make sure that you hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. I'll see you in the next one. Okay, bye.